Hi everyone, welcome to this session. I am Vibina, faculty of microbiology department, e-content development center, Majlis Arts and Science College, Poramannur. In this video lecture, we will be going to discuss the linkage and crossing over in organisms. We know that linkage and crossing over are the two different but interrelated genetic events in eukaryotic organism. Before entering into the main session, I would be like to tell you the relation between cells, DNA, chromosomes and genes. We know that cells are the building block of each organisms. In humans, there are trillions of cells. In each cell, there is a nucleus. We know that nucleus are the commanding center of cells. Okay, or they are act as the houses of DNA. What is DNA? DNA is the hereditary materials, okay? And this DNA composed of polynucleotide sequence. In each nucleus, the DNA package like thread-like structure called chromosomes. Each chromosomes made up with so many genes. We know that the genes are the physical and functional unit of chromosomes. That means they are inheritance, the character of a particular trait, while the DNA inherit all the information of all the character of an organism. So let's start with the introduction to linkage. According to chromosome theory of inheritance, the chromosomes are made up with so many genes. Okay, we know that each organism possesses different characters, and these characters are controlled by many genes. Okay, so the number of genes exceeds the number of chromosome pairs. That means the chromosomes are made up with the different genes. Okay, in some cases at the time of meiosis, some genes are not assert, means they are not separated. Otherwise, they inherited together to their offsprings. They are called linkage. So, what do you mean by linkage? The phenomena of inheritance of genes together and to retain their parental combination even in the offspring. It is known as linkage. Okay. Next, we discuss the history of linkage. Actually, in 1911, Morgan, one of the famous scientists, proposed the theory of linkage. Before that, this theory was proposed under different name. First one is Sutton hypothesis. In 1902, one of the famous scientists, Sutton, suggests that each chromosome bears more than one gene, and all these genes situated in one chromosomes inherited together to their offsprings. Unfortunately, he was unable to explain his finding. So, in 1906, Bateson and Punnett, who proposed another theory called coupling and repulsion hypothesis. They suggest that the allele coming from same parent tend to enter the same gamete and be inherited together. This is called a genetic coupling. He proposed another theory called repulsion. Okay, that means the repulsion theory suggests that same gene coming from two different parents tend to enter the different gamete and to be inherited together or separately and independently. They inherited separated and independently. Bateson and Punnett also couldn't explain his findings. So, in 1910, Morgan proposed the theory of linkage based on the coupling and repulsion theory. They suggest that the tendency of the gene being present in the same chromosome remain in their original combination and enter together into the same gamete. Okay, in 1911, finally, Morgan and another one of the famous scientists, Carl Steele, proposed the chromosome theory of linkage. Today, this theory helped in the construction of linkage map of chromosomes. Okay. Next, we discuss the linkage genes and linkage group. What do you mean by linkage genes? We know that the genes located in the same chromosomes and being inherited together, they are known as linked gene. Here you can see the image of chromosomes. Here we can see the gene A, gene B, C, D, E and F. Here we can see that the genes are arranged linearly. So, the arrangement of linked gene in chromosome is linear in positions. Okay, and all those genes which are located in the same chromosome called a linkage group. The number of linkage group equal to the number of chromosome pairs. For example, in human there are 23 pairs of chromosomes, and these 23 numbers of chromosomes equal to their linkage group. That means in human there are 23 linkage group. Next, we discuss the arrangement of linked gene. How the genes are arranged in chromosomes? Mainly, there are two types of arrangement: cis arrangement and trans arrangement. First, we go through the cis arrangement. In DNA, the dominant genes, here you can see the cis arrangement. The dominant genes of each pairs, they are present in the one member of chromosome, or the dominant genes present in the one member of the chromosome, or the one chromatid of the chromosomes, and the recessive gene of these two pairs present in the another chromatid or another member of the chromosomes. This type of arrangement is known as cis arrangement. What is cis arrangement? In chromosomes, the dominant gene present in one chromatid and the recessive gene present in another chromatid. This type of arrangement is known as cis arrangement. Okay, next we discuss the trans arrangement. In trans arrangement, the one member or one chromatid of chromosome contain both dominant and recessive genes, and also the another chromatid or another member of the chromosome contain the recessive and dominant genes. This type of arrangement is known as trans arrangement. Okay. Next, we discuss the another important process, crossing over. What do you mean by crossing over? Crossing over is the exchange of genetic material between the non-sister chromatid of homologous chromosome. This happened during the period of meiosis. Okay. Here you can see the non-sister chromatids of homologous chromosome. In meiosis, at the stage of prophase 1, the maternal and paternal chromosomes, that means the chromosome from mother and the chromosome from parent, come close together, and they start to exchange their genetic material. They exchange their genetic material at a particular point called a chiasma. What you mean by chiasma? The chiasma means the point at which the chromosomes start to exchange their genetic material. So what is the result? The result is new one. That means the recombinant one. This figure explains the comparison of linkage and crossing over. Here you can see the cell. The cell contains paternal and maternal chromosome. After DNA replication, they synthesize their sister chromatids. Suppose the genes present in the chromosomes are close together. They undergoes linkage. That means the new one or the progeny got the genetic information from their parent as such. Okay. So, if the genes are far apart, there is a chance for crossing over. That means they exchange their genetic material. So the result will be new one. That means the recombinant one. Next, we discuss the type of crossing over. There are mainly three type of crossing over: single crossing over, double crossing over, and multiple crossing over. In single crossing over, as the name suggests, there is one chiasma formation, or there is one crossing over between the non-sister chromatids of homologous chromosomes. In this such cross, only two chromatids are involved out of four. Okay. Next, we discuss the double crossing over. As the name suggests, there are two chiasma, or there are two breakage and reunion of chromatids. In such cases, they involve either two strand, three strand, and in some case, four strands are involved in this type of crossing over. Next, we discuss the multiple crossing over. As the name suggests, there are two chiasma form. There are more than two chiasma formation. That means there are more than two, three, or four breakage at non-sister chromatids of homologous chromosome. In such type, or the frequency of such type of crossing over is extremely low. There is less chance for crossing over, or their frequency is less compared to single and double crossing over. Next, we discuss the factors which affecting the linkage and crossing over. There are so many factors which affect linkage and crossing over. First one is distance. How the distance affect linkage and crossing over? Consider, suppose In these chromosomes, these two genes, means gene 1 and gene 2, they are arranged closely. There is chance for linkage and there are no chance for crossing over. The another example here, we can see that the gene 1 and gene 2 are far apart. They are situated far apart. So here the crossing over, the frequency of crossing over is increases, and also there is less chance for linkage. So the distance which directly proportional to the crossing over and indirectly proportional to the linkage. That means the distance increases, there is a chance for crossing over, and the distance decreases, there is a chance for linkage. Next we discuss the age of the animal. The age of the animal increases, there is a chance for linkage. That means as the age increases, there is a less chance for crossing over, or the increases of age which affect the frequency of crossing over. Okay, next we discuss the temperature. The increase or decrease of temperature will affect the frequency of crossing over positively. That means the temperature directly proportional to crossing over and indirectly proportional to linkage. Next we discuss the X-rays. If chromosomes are exposed to X-ray or any other radiations, it will increase the frequency of crossing over. That means the exposure to X-ray will indirectly proportional to crossing over and indirectly proportional to linkage. Next we discuss the other factors which affect crossing over. One of the important factor is chemicals. We know that some chemicals act as mutagens, and these chemicals will affect the frequency of crossing over. Some chemicals positively affect the frequency of crossing over and some others negatively affect the frequency of crossing over. Okay. Next we discuss the sex of an animal. For example, in male Drosophila, the linkage, the frequency of linkage is less, and also in female silk moth, the frequency of linkage is low. Next one is chiasmata formation. What do you mean by chiasmata? The point at which the chromosomes break and rejoin, and at this point they exchange their genetic material. Okay. So the chiasmata formation in one chromosome will affect the formation of another chiasmata, or the chance of crossing over is less. Another one is cytoplasm. We know that the cytoplasm contain all the factors for crossing over. So these factors inherited to their together to their offsprings. And another important one is nutritional effect. The nutrients such as metal ions, calcium and magnesium will reduce the frequency of crossing over. Okay. Another important factor is chromosome structure effect. If any abnormalities in the chromosome, that means the arrangement of linked genes, if there is any abnormalities in the arrangement of linked genes in each chromosome, this will affect the crossing over process. This reduces the frequency of crossing over. Another important one is centromere effect. Consider, suppose if the genes are located close to the centromere region, it will reduce the frequency of crossing over. So these are the factors which affect the process of crossing over. Next we discuss the type of linkage. The linkage are mainly divided into complete and incomplete linkage. First we go through the complete linkage. What do you mean by complete linkage? Complete linkage means linkage of genes on a chromosome which is not altered and is inherited as such from generation to generation without any crossing over. This is called a complete linkage. That is the transfer of the genetic material from parent to generation without any alteration or without any crossing over is called a complete linkage. That means the offspring got the genetic material from their parent as such. Okay. Here we take the example, gray colored. Here you can see the two type of Drosophila, gray color body and long wings, and another one is black color body and vestigial wings, and their genotype designated as capital GG and capital LL. That means the capital G which denote the gray color body and capital L which denote the long wings. Okay. In this case, the small letter G which denote the black color body and the small letter L which denote the vestigial wings. Okay. In this figure, you can clear the complete linkage. Here we cross the grey body color and long wings male Drosophila with the black body color and vestigial wings female Drosophila. In the F1 generation, we got grey body color and long wings, and the genotype designated as GLGL, that is they are heterozygous. Okay, consider this grey color body and long wing offspring fertilized with the recessive character, that means black color body and long wing female Drosophila. We got the progenies like a 50-50, that means the 50% of the progeny show grey color body and long wings, and another 50% show black color body and vestigial wings. Here you can see that the gene which control the color of the body, that means here the grey and black color. Okay, so the gene which control the color of the body inherited together with the gene which control the shape of the wings, that means the long or vestigial, and the parents the offspring got the genetic information from their parent as such. Next we discuss the incomplete linkage. Incomplete linkage is very common in all organisms. Okay, in majority of the cases, the homologous chromosomes undergo breakage and reunion during gametogenesis. Okay, so during this reunion and breakage, they exchange some of their genetic material. Here we take the example, the maize color. Here we cross the colored and full seed with the colorless and shrunken seed, and their gamete denoted as capital C and capital S. Capital C denote the colored seed and capital S denote the full seed. And here the small letter C which denote the colorless seed and the small letter S which denote the shrunken seed. In this figure, you can clear the difference between linkage and crossing over. Here we take or we cross the colored full seed maize with the colorless shrunken seed. In the F1 generation, we got the progenies like a colored full seed. Okay. Suppose the genes present on these chromatids are close together, there is a chance for linkage. Okay. So we cross the colored full seed with the colorless shrunken seed. So the progenies are colored full seed and a colorless shrunken seed, and these characters are inherited together. That means the color of the maize and the shape of the seed, the gene which control these together are inherited together to their offspring. That means the offspring got their genetic material from their parent as such. Okay. So what is happening in another case? Here we can see that if the genes are situated far apart, there is a chance for crossing over. So they exchange their genetic material, and the result is new one or the hybrid one. If this new gamete or this hybrid gamete cross with the recessive character, we got the progenies like a colored shrunken and colorless full seed. That means they are new or they are recombinant ones. I hope this video lecture will clear the aspect. Thank you for watching. Thank you so much.